Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, DwyerVIP.com for free premium sports picks. Look us up in the sports section on Roku. We're there. Dwyer Boxing and Sports News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, I hope I have solved the audio problems of the last video to everyone who tried to listen to what I was saying in that video. I apologize profusely. This is a work in progress. Sometimes I'm going to get it right. Sometimes I'm going to get it wrong. People are laughing at me here in the background. Sometimes I'm going to get it wrong. I got it wrong in the last video in terms of the audio. As for the pick, Robert Guerrero delivered the win. He did not do it by knockout. He didn't deliver the way, but he did deliver the win. Now let me say this, and I'm going to ramble a little bit here. I was looking at a video of, an audio of Pat Riley talking about LeBron James and the Miami Heat. By the way, LeBron, I hope you do the right thing and get out of that town. But, you know, Pat Riley had a lot of choice lines to say. Basically, Pat Riley wants LeBron James back with the Heat, and of course, to do so, Pat wants to position himself as a father figure, right, for LeBron James. Well, let me say this. Pat, haven't you made enough money off LeBron James? Haven't you made millions of dollars already off LeBron James? The point is that these athletes, quite frankly, have people around them with their own agendas. To LeBron James, the question is, who do you want to give your money to? Your family? Or to Pat Riley and Miami Heat ownership, right? The people around you have their own agendas. A lot of people are making a lot of money off of you. To the younger people, and by younger I mean people of fighting age, right? 30s and 20s. You need to just assume that everyone, and that includes me, has a hidden agenda, right? Everyone has a vested interest in something, right? So as people around you are giving advice, you need to think about their self-interest versus your self-interest. If you're looking for family, don't look for it in business relationships, right? Let's talk about Robert Guerrero. Now, I picked Guerrero in the fight, but I hope Guerrero looks at the film carefully. Right, the film is not going to be kind to him. I know right now, no doubt, you've heard about the judges' scorecards. They were wide. You've heard that Robert Guerrero sucked it up, put on a show, won a shootout, won the decision. But here's the problem. Robert Guerrero's in his 30s right now. There's some young pups out there, and they're dangerous. Right, Sean Porter, I'm talking about you. Amir Khan, I'm talking about you. Cal Brook, I'm talking about you. Keith Thurman, who? Robert Guerrero's father is mentioned, I'm talking about you. These guys are too dangerous, in my opinion. And I'm in Northern California. I'm here representing wearing a Giants jersey. And trust me, I'm not doing it for this video. Right? I'm in Northern California. I'm in Robert Guerrero's backyard. And I can tell you that if I were Robert Guerrero, I would look at the film and I would ask myself, did I get hit too much in this fight? Is there a round in this fight where Robert Guerrero is not getting hit with power punches multiple times? Right? In my opinion, Guerrero gets hit more in this fight than I've ever seen Bernard Hopkins hit in a fight or Floyd Mayweather. Right? Understand. About as bad as it's gotten for Bernard was the Jean Pascal fight. About as bad, in my opinion, as it's gotten for Floyd was the Shane Mosley fight. There, the guys got hit hard in one or two rounds. Then they recovered, then their defense and their brilliance and their angles took over. Here, Robert Guerrero is getting battered for several rounds. Now, what I'm going to say is going to sound controversial. You have to figure out my agenda, right? Is it to help one of these younger guys with foot speed, with talent, like Sean Porter or Amir Khan, or is it to help Robert Guerrero's health on the long term? Let me just say, I'm a child of the 70s. Many of our heroes in the 70s, the best interviews in the sport of boxing in the 70s. Right? Muhammad Ali. I'm telling you, Joe Frazier used to be a great interview in the 1970s. Right? You get to now, and poor Ali isn't a great interview anymore. Joe Frazier is no longer with us. The problem with brain injury, just look at what's happening in the NFL. Junior Seau, Dave Duerson. The problem with brain injury is that it doesn't show itself for several years. Then when it does, it's too late. Now in boxing, they say that the legs are the first to go. Right? Power seems to be the last to go. If you're a power puncher, you seem to have that up until your next to last day in the ring. But with the legs, it's different. And let me say this about Robert Guerrero. As a viewer here, Sniper, I believe his name is, pointed out in the comment section to my pre-fight video, Guerrero hasn't had a stoppage above 135 pounds. Now, he's fighting at 147. The power is not what it used to be. And let me say, nor are the legs. He's fighting a guy who's running red lights, right? Kamage is a guy who's right in front of you. He's Derek Chisora, right? He's not even trying to avoid getting hit. It's a shootout, right? He's there thinking that he can back you up against the ropes and then overpower you. That's his game. He's not worried about whether he's right in front of you, whether you can hit him with either hand or anything like that. Now, against a fighter like this, you need to move around the ring. You need to use movement to create openings, to keep him guessing on where you're going to be, and to then use those openings to land punches. I didn't see Robert Guerrero do that. More disturbingly, I didn't see Robert Guerrero do that against Selkuk Aydın or against Andre Berto. So what we're talking about is a guy who, granted, he hadn't been in the ring a year, but is it rust or is it age? Understand, we're in a new era of boxing where you have a lot of guys who are defying age, right? You know, I'd even put people like Vladimir Klitschko in that category, Antonio Tarver. Right, you're talking about guys who are over 35. Understand, Marvelous Marvin Hagler, in a different era in boxing, walked away from the sport at 32. Take a look at the trajectory of Joe Louis's career, the great Joe Louis. And you're going to find that, you know, Joe, by the time he's in his mid-30s, isn't Joe. That's the way boxing is. Now, Robert Guerrero's already in his 30s, and I'm just here to tell you, and I'll try to be as blunt as possible, his legs are gone. Right? Now, this is from someone who picked him in the fight. I'm happy he won. I'm not going to give any money back to the casino on the fight. But his legs aren't sufficient enough for him to avoid shootouts against guys who are obviously on their front foot and whose game plan is very obvious, like Yoshihiro Kamage. Right? So what I saw in this fight was a skilled fighter. Right? Robert Guerrero is a guy who can sit at the chessboard and outthink and outmove you. But understand, he, in my opinion, takes more punishment than even Ali took in the Rumble in the Jungle. Right? His head is snapping the entire fight. I thought he'd be able to land uppercuts. He was. He was able to land a lot of big punches. At 147, he's not the puncher Keith Thurman is. Kamage was right in front of him. What surprised me in this fight, and it surprised me, was the ease. And I mean ease, at which Kamage was able to land power punches. I'm not talking about flash punches. I'm talking about uppercuts. I'm talking about hooks on Robert Guerrero. Look at Guerrero's eye. Right? On the telecast, they kept showing you the punch that blew up his eye. What's interesting is he gets hit with that punch. Then he gets hit with other big punches that same round. Don't view the age of fighters chronologically. I think that's a mistake. View it in terms of how much punishment they've taken. Right? Robert Guerrero's reflexes have dimmed. Robert Guerrero's ability to move around the ring has dimmed. I was a bit surprised that Guerrero didn't try to have this front foot heavy opponent following him, walking into punches. When I see a guy as caught on the side of the ring as much as Robert Guerrero, getting hit as hard as Robert Guerrero, something's wrong. This is different than Floyd on the side of the ring. Understand, Floyd on the side of the ring has his defense up. He's bobbing and weaving and leaning. What you don't see when Mayweather's up on the side of the ring is Mayweather's head getting snapped and hit as much as Robert Guerrero's. Right? Quite frankly, Guerrero today is probably sore all over. Guerrero's neck today, it's probably very sore. In the post-fight interview with Jim Gray, Guerrero actually mentioned the fact that Kamage has punching power. He should know, because he was hit with Kamage shots dozens of times. His foot speed is below Sean Porter's, Kell Brook's, Amir Khan's, and Keith Thurman's. I know his father is colorful. His father wants him to fight Keith Thurman next. You've got to be kidding me. I'd take Keith Thurman in that fight. Keith Thurman not only hits harder than Robert Guerrero right now, Keith Thurman moves better in the ring. Boxing is a young man's sport. So I have to tell you, if I were Robert Guerrero, and I understand this post-fight video is unconventional, and I understand Robert Guerrero won the fight, even on my scorecard, by several rounds, right? He is a better chess player than Kamage. But if I'm Robert Guerrero at this point, I need to start thinking about leaving the sport. I know that sounds heavy, especially when the guy's well-connected. He's with Golden Boy. He's in line for a title shot. If I were him, I'd see where this title shot takes me. Then even if I win the title, I would get out of the sport. Robert Guerrero has made millions of dollars in the sport of boxing. Understand, it's those last few million dollars that jeopardize your health. Right? I'm sure the people who love Ali cringe at the thought of him fighting Trevor Burbeck and Larry Holmes in his last couple of fights. The guys ruling the roost or near the top of the roost at 147, they're hungry. Some of them hit awfully hard. Keith Thurman, his nickname is One Touch. Why? Because one touch sometimes is all it takes. You can't cannot get hit like Robert Guerrero has been hit. You can't lose your legs like Robert Guerrero has lost his legs and expect to compete against, we'll call them the usual suspects, right? Sean Porter, Kell Brook, Amir Khan, Keith Thurman, right? So let me just say, I'm thrilled Robert Guerrero won the fight. I think Robert Guerrero was one of the classiest guys in the sport of boxing. But if the people around him have his best interest at heart and not their best interest, somebody is going to have to say to him, it's time to step away from the sport, or at least you need to think about an exit strategy. Right? If you're in his corner, and if he's getting hit like this against Keith Thurman, and if he ends up getting hurt, staggered around the ring, look at his eye at the end of this fight. By the way, just look at his eye at the end of this fight. Right? If he's getting hit like this, and let's say he's worse off, let's say he's not winning the fight like he was here, I would hope a guy in his corner would say, hey, it's time we pull the plug. Put it this way. Apart from the first two rounds, I don't even think Sergio Martinez against Miguel Cotto got hit like this. Now, it would be different if it's an isolated incident. If you say, okay, he had a bad night. That happens to fighters. But I'll tell you what, when the bad nights start to add up, when Selkirk Aydın, Andre Berto are caught up in shootouts with you, when Carmagate's caught up in a shootout with you, and Floyd Mayweather has the very high percentages in terms of punches landed that he had against you, I think you need to be honest with yourself. You've had a great career. If I were Robert Guerrero, I would say, okay, let me fight the best. Right? If Mayweather gives me a rematch, great, I'll take that rematch, right? Why? Because Mayweather is top of the food chain. Right? If Keith Thurman gives me a shot, I'll take that fight. Why? Because Keith Thurman is one of the very best at 147 pounds. If the winner of Sean Porter, Kell Brook gives me a shot at their title, I'd take that. Why? It's a championship match against one of the best at 147 pounds. But if I'm Robert Guerrero, I would stay away from anyone who's not wearing a belt. And I would literally limit myself to one last assault on the championship. Win, lose, or draw, even if I were to win the title, I would walk away from the sport. Right? Guerrero needs to think about fighters like Wilfred Benitez. Great fighter, according to reports, suffering from brain injury right now. He needs to think about Ali. He needs to think about many of these fighters who took a lot of headshots and who right now have slurred speech. There are many of them, for purposes of protecting their identities and their quality of life. I'm not going to mention any names there. But he needs to think about them. He even needs to think about some fighters who were very good fighters in an earlier generation. Jerry Quarry. Mike Quarry. Right? Mike Quarry had game too. Right? Jimmy Young. One of my favorite fighters ever. Jimmy Ellis, who recently died. Even great fighters. Sugar Ray Robinson. He needs to look at Ray Robinson and Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. Right? If I'm Robert Guerrero with a family, he has a gorgeous wife, he has a family. If I'm him with money in the bank, he's made millions. I would think about all of them as I look at the video of this fight. Carmagate has some skills, but he shouldn't be hitting any elite fighter as much as he hit Robert Guerrero. Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here on film. Briefly, let me just say I was shocked at how Guerrero wasn't able to move around the ring. I was shocked at how Guerrero could not maintain distance. Kamage, to me, was just trying to smother him. And Guerrero couldn't do much about it. It was shocking. Let me hear from you. Thanks for stopping by.